Is there such a thing called quantum memory? Well, what does first of all mainstream science say about quantum memory? Because it is now something that is being used frequently to store quantum information. And this is being explored in many areas through technology. This is a critical component of what we call quantum computing and quantum communication, as it allows for the preservation of quantum states, which can be used for sophisticated calculations and secure communication. So here are the key characteristics of quantum memory. Number one, quantum states. Quantum memory stores quantum information in the form of quantum states, which represent the superposition of multiple classical states. This enables the memory to store multiple bits of information simultaneously, opening up possibilities for exponentially more powerful computations. Number two, there's a phenomenon called decoherence resistance. Quantum memory must be resistant to decoherence, which is the tendency of quantum states to lose their coherence and collapse into classical states due to interactions with the environment. This is a major challenge in quantum computing, as decoherence can quickly destroy the delicate quantum information. And then there are other issues that discuss quantum information, long storage times, etc., etc. And there are many types of quantum memory. Photonic memories, these memories store quantum information in the polarization or phase of single photons or entangled photon pairs. They are well suited for long distance quantum communication, as they can efficiently transmit quantum information over optical fibers. Then there is electromagnetically induced transparency memories, and these memories use something called EIT, which I don't fully understand, but it's a phenomenon in which a material becomes transparent to a specific wavelength of light when it is illuminated with two other beams of light. And then there are some things called solid state memories, and the applications of quantum memory include quantum computing, quantum communication, quantum simulation, etc., etc. So this is a rapidly evolving field, but my interest goes a little beyond that, and that is there quantum memory in the universe? Is there quantum memory in the universe? And this is a complex issue that is not really being addressed, but it has been hinted at. One such theory is the holographic principle, which states that all the information in the universe is encoded on the boundary of space-time. This means that the information about the entire universe could be stored in a very small region of space, such as the surface of a black hole. Another possibility is that the universe is itself a quantum computer. This has been suggested by, of course, physicalists. In this view, the fabric of space-time would be made up of qubits, the basic units of quantum information. This would allow the universe to store and process information in a way that is fundamentally different from classical computers. So the questions being addressed right now are, could the universe store quantum information? What is the nature of quantum memory? How could we access and potentially manipulate that quantum memory? But let's not stop there. Is genetic information quantum memory? And so, once again, quantum memory is the ability of a quantum system to store information in a quantum state. This means that the information can be in a superposition of states, which allows it to be processed in a way that is not possible with classical information. DNA, the molecule that contains genetic information, is a complex molecule that is made up of four different bases, ATCG, adenine, guanine, cytosine, thymine. These bases can be arranged in a variety of ways, which gives rise to different genetic codes for different organisms. So, is it possible that the arrangement of bases in DNA may be influenced by quantum effects? For example, it has been shown that DNA can undergo quantum tunneling, which is a process that allows particles to move through barriers that they would not be able to pass through in the classical world. So, of course, scientists are skeptical about this, but I think it's worth exploring. And since there is quantum memory, is there something maybe called quantum imagination? So this is the most interesting part, that some fringe scientists are suggesting. I've always believed in it, of course, because Vedanta holds that consciousness, the field of consciousness, is more fundamental than even quantum field, and it's a qualia field. But let's explore the idea of quantum imagination. One of the most striking aspects of quantum mechanics is the concept of superposition. Superposition states that a quantum system can exist in multiple states simultaneously until it is measured. This is in stark contrast to classical physics, where a system can only be in one state at a time. The implications of superposition are profound, and they have led to some of the most mind-boggling paradoxes in physics. Imagination, too, seems to exhibit a kind of superposition. We can imagine multiple possibilities and outcomes for a given situation without committing to any one of them. The ability to hold multiple possibilities in mind is essential for creative thinking and problem solving. Another parallel between imagination and quantum mechanics is the concept of entanglement. So entanglement occurs when two or more quantum states are linked in such a way that they cannot be described independently. This means that the actions of one system can instantaneously affect the other, even if they are separated by a great distance. Imagination can also be seen as a kind of entanglement. When we imagine something, we are essentially linking our present reality with a hypothetical future and a possibility. This connection between our present and future selves is what allows us to plan, dream, and innovate. So, here are some examples of what imagination might be related to quantum mechanics. Imagination allows us to connect with and explore new possibilities. This is similar to the way that quantum systems can exist in multiple states simultaneously. Imagination can lead to novel solutions to problems. This is similar to the way quantum systems can exhibit what is called emergent behavior. Imagination can be used to create art and beauty. This is similar to the way that quantum systems can give rise to the colorful patterns we see in nature. These are just a few examples that suggest that imagination may have a deeper connection to quantum mechanics than mainstream physicists have even considered. And of course, as we explore this realm of thinking, I think this realm of thinking has the potential to revolutionize our understanding of consciousness and creativity. Let me know your thoughts. Link between the universe recycling as the atoms in our body, atoms having quantum mechanical behavior, genes encoding quantum memory, and the quantum mind, which is both memory and imagination, actually as the source of creativity and evolution. I love this kind of thinking, even though it might turn out to be totally fringe or false. But then the question arises, who's the I that is thinking about this thinking? What is the I that knows that it knows, or the I that knows that it doesn't know?